an interview situation like the one that I've experienced, then you've just got to be aware that, these things are quite serious, and it's not just a 15-minute chat. You've actually, you know, if you do want the job, you've got to go in there and you've got to be prepared for it could be a 3-day interview like the one that I've experienced, or it could be just an hour. But you know, you have to do, you have to be prepared, and you have to take it serious.
A little good advice for those in the know goes a long way in the cutthroat world out there. So what advice do our people have in terms of getting ahead in their industry and in business in general?
It's vital that people have something extra on their CV when they come into a role. It's really good to see what interests they've followed and what extra things they've done to show that they're interested in the subject, or simply that they've tried out some of the things that they're going to be involved with in the future. So, you know, if someone's worked at a manufacturer, or if they've worked within retail, then they're going to empathise far more with the culture and the work that we do subsequently. It's good to have people who've got some realism as opposed to just the theory.
One of the things I tell candidates that are thinking about coming into Vodafone is to be prepared to learn and grow. More than anything else, if people come in with a willingness to learn new things, new skills, new trades, etc., and to grow along the way, to be open to feedback, to be open to getting better and better, you have a great career to look forward to. And if people come in with that mindset, coupled with what the company wants to do to grow people, it is a winning combination, learning and growing. So I hope to see a lot of new talent come into the organization.
I would say definitely what is key is you have to be patient. The customers constantly change what they want doing. So if you get worked up by it, you're never going to be comfortable working for them or working for anyone else. And definitely attention to detail, because we're basically selling systems which are worth hundreds of millions of dollars. So you've got to make sure you get everything right. And I suppose you've got to be quite pragmatic and rationalise what you're going to do and how you're going to sell that to the customer. I would say those are three key things.
I think the advice for any students would be, look, when you're looking for a firm, look for a firm that is prepared to progress you if you work hard. I know there's a few schemes where, you know, perhaps although they advertise them as graduate schemes, they're actually just looking to fill a position. There isn't a clearly defined training plan there, which is not the case with us. We, you know, there really is that development need done.
I think you've got to be a really good people person. We work for a lot of clients, so essentially you've got to build that relationship right from the start. You've got to be thinking, I think, outside the box a little bit more. It can't be that age-old grind. It's got to be, right, what can we do new? You know, Tesco are a massive client, and their competitors are always going to be trying to do something a little bit different, trying to beat us some way. So we've always got to be thinking, right, what can we do differently? Where can we go that we haven't gone before? I think that's, yeah, so long as you think not down that straight and narrow line.
In every career, there's a certain set of skills and attributes that will initially get you noticed and eventually enable you to progress to the next level. Obviously, different industries will be looking for different things. The enumerate accountant and the agoraphobic firefighter are almost certainly destined for failure. So what kind of things do our interviewees think you need to work in their industries?
I think the key qualities that people need are those that are outside of what they've probably learned at a university, outside of the technical things that they do. It's those qualities of having an open mind, of good communication with people, of being brave with decision making and being prepared to share those with other people. But the biggest one of all is teamwork. I think that's something that we as employers are always looking for. It's people who will fully engage with those around them and respect the other people for their decisions as well.
We hire both introverts and extroverts. Now, extroverts are fantastic communicators, and in interview situations, you're obviously very drawn to someone who's a good communicator. But introverts do extremely well at Dunnhumby because a lot of what we do is a science, and so it is considered opinion that at the end of the day, wins out. So actually having people who can really understand and learn from the data and the insight, and who can then develop a relationship with the client that's around deep knowledge and trust, becomes the most differentiating factor.
The world of work wouldn't be complete without its challenges. Granted, it'd be a hell of a lot easier, less stressful and more enjoyable, but hey, who needs plain sailing? Give me a dinghy, some water wings and 4 or 5 hurricanes any day of the week. Piece of cake, just make sure it's Battenberg. Anyway, what kind of challenges do our interviewees have to face up to?
I'm faced with new challenges every day, and you've just got to embrace each one. Some of them are more difficult than others, but the reward at the end of it is quite satisfying, and that's why I'm here.
The biggest challenges are, I think, adapting to change. As a business, we keep innovating on our products, the things that we can do with the data and the applications. So I think it's important for anyone coming into this industry to be able to adapt to change and actually like an environment that changes regularly. The other thing is to keep abreast of what's going on in the industry. Things move very fast in fast-moving consumer goods, unsurprisingly, and things change at our clients, and it's important that we understand their changing needs so we can give them what it is they really want.
When you're applying for any job, with the right preparation, you can improve your chances dramatically against the legions of other applicants you may be competing with. So, what is the recruitment process like in a nutshell, and what makes a good applicant and a good application?
We're looking for people who are outgoing, with get up and go, who clearly like to be busy in their private life as well as in their academic life. We're looking for people who've demonstrated intellectual curiosity. We're not necessarily looking for any particular courses. It is helpful to have done a relevant course such as business and management. However, we have a lot of senior managers here whose degrees have been in things like geography, economics, politics, the arts. If a candidate has strong academic ability and has demonstrated that they have a lot of interests in their spare time that are relevant, then we'll be very interested in them.